Hello everybody, welcome to the channel. In this video, I am going to install Windows XP Professional on my e-machine. So, this is, if you saw my previous video, you saw how I got it. This, we're going to see if Windows XP will install on it. So, without further ado, let's get started. I did shoot this video before, but unfortunately my camera died, so I have to use an old phone here to do it. So I am going to power it on. So now I'm going to set the KVM switch to number 2. I thought I didn't have the disk in the drive, so now I'm going to forcefully shut it down. And on this particular computer, you push F10. So we're going to go to CD-ROM. This is the only drive I have in there right now. I had to pull the Blu-ray out and the sound card out because that was a family member's stuff, and they paid a lot of money for it, so it was better off that I gave it to them. So, without further ado, let's install. Let me turn the camera this way. A little more. So I'm going to do number 1 here. I'm just going to tweak camera again. There we go. Now, the last time I did this, I did get Windows XP to work. As you will see, and I'll tell you this, everything worked except for the network interface card. With that, what happened was, is Windows loaded a default driver, an OEM driver, and it would not connect to the internet because I needed a specific driver. But with this computer, I'm going to use it for a specific purpose that does not require that, so that doesn't matter to me. So what I'm going to do here, so I'm going to turn this up. Okay, so as you can see, it did work. So as usual, we're going to do D, enter L. We're going to do this. We're going to do the quick. Now, as I've stated before in my other videos, when you're building a computer for somebody in a certain type of environment, I'm not sure if I have said this or not, you want to do things quick as possible. That's because if you don't, you can get in trouble or whatever. But if the quick doesn't work, then you do it the other way. I've only had maybe once or twice where the quick format did not work for me. And now, as you can see, we are there. So now what's going to happen is we're going to be in the visual part of this. Thank you. So as usual, you accept the license agreement here. And when I did this the first time, it actually installed it quite quickly. What I noticed about Windows XP, I'm not sure if I said this or not, is if the computer is newer, a generation newer, than when the new computers were around, when XP was the newest thing, it tends not to take as much time to install. So as usual, I name all my computers test. Not all of them, just these. All right, so you have the work group option, and then you have a domain. I'm not sure if I have said this or not. A domain is a company website. That is your main server. This is at my home. I don't have that set up, so I'm going to do a work group. So I'm just going to do test. Now, I know a lot of people that love this particular operating system. XP actually ran under Windows 95 and 98. So what Microsoft decided to do was take that, what I call underprogramming, and make an operating system. This operating system was extremely versatile and ran on multiple things. It's not going to exactly take 18 minutes. There's hardly anything to this computer right now. What I have in here is I literally have, obviously, the board, which is the computer, the power supply to run it, memory, and a hard drive. That's it. I had to, as I said earlier in the video, I had to take a couple parts out because they were our family members and I didn't want to use them. Because they paid for them and I didn't want to, I didn't ask permission to use them, so I had to give them back. So we're at the final bit of the setup here. It says it's going to take 7 minutes, but it only took 2 when I did it the last time. And here we go. As you see, we have the boot splash screen. This is the first, if I explained this before, this is the first run of the installation. That's why it says please wait, because XP itself has to figure out what's going on. And there we go, this is the track for the final of the installation. So as you see, the sound works. So next. I'm not going to do that right now. We're going to skip this. I click finish. Listen to this. So the sound and the graphics are fine. It is going to take a little bit to go into the desktop. Onto the desktop, excuse me. There we go. So, it recognized the changes. Windows 10, Windows 8, 7, Vista, even 98 will do this. Now, during this era, when Vista first came out, they wanted everybody to use that. So what they were doing, some computers actually had, it was mostly laptops from my experience, that had these hardware firewalls on them, on the board itself. So if you try to install Windows XP, you could tell when it went to the visual, the GUI, it would all the lines where it says installing, gathering information and stuff like that would all say the same thing, and you knew it was blocked. Now, when the desktop shows up, I will show you that this actually works. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to properties here. We're going to go to desktop, appearance, excuse me. We're going to go to Windows XP style. Now, the time you want to, for me, you want to use the classic style is if you have an older computer that can handle this and this particular appearance is taking too much memory, you turn that down and there's less memory it will use to keep that up. So, anyway, so I am going to go to the start menu. You go to all programs and we'll go to accessories here. PaintWorks. That works. This 3D pinball is one of the best games. That I think Microsoft has ever put on an operating system. I haven't found a version that is compatible with the new one. I want to find that out, and when I do, I will make a video of it. So, this game works. And just to show you, I'm running Windows XP Professional version 2002. 2002 is when this operating system came out. So, Service Pack 3, I'm running an AMD, which stands for Advanced Micro Technologies, by the way, if you wanted to know that. Processor, 2.7 gigs of RAM, even though I have more than that in there. So, anyway, that is it for this video. Please comment, like, and subscribe.